favorite seasonal YouTuber is back, 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 back again with some more EUROSIS. We're going to be listening to Eurovision songs 2022. I hope you're excited as much as I am. So yeah, let's see. Today we're going to be listening to Albania, Bulgaria, Czech Republic, Estonia, Ireland, Israel, Italy, and Latvia. Because this is a very early stage, we don't actually have a lot of music videos for these songs, so it's mostly going to be live performances. And yeah, let's get to it. Okay, so the first artist on our list is Ronela Hayati from Albania. So according to what I read on the Eurovision website, she participated in many talent shows and festivals in Albania. She's apparently pretty popular there and well known. And what I find very interesting is she wrote the song that we're going to listen to herself. There's a very important thing that I forgot to say at the very beginning of this video is that I am not going to be doing reaction videos this year because I realize that very often how I feel about the songs changes. So it's not maybe the best representation of my true opinion. So yeah, that's how we're going to do it this year. So I have actually listened to all of these songs a couple of times. So, I have already some opinions about them, some feelings about them, and I'm just going to share them with you. So it's going to be more of a review video. Right, so Ronela Hayati was chosen for national selection in Albania, so yay! And the song is in Albanian, so yay! There is going to be like one line in English in the chorus, but apart from that, I think it's all in Albanian, so that's awesome. So this is the final performance from the Albanian national selection. So it starts off like a ballad. You would expect something very similar to the Albanian 2021 entry and 2019 entry, right? But you're in for a surprise. She's emoting so much on the stage. I love that. The heavy breathing. And you can see in her face, she's so happy to be there and be performing on that stage. That's cool. See, I told you. It's not a ballad. Ah! I love all like ethnic things. So I love the sound of those. I think those are bagpipes or some kind. Very nice. So, yeah, what do you guys think? I think that this had great energy. The only problem that I have with this song is that it gives me a little bit of that vibe of Queen of the Night from last year. Remember the Latvian entry? It feels a little bit disjointed. Having listened to it a couple of times, like I said, it doesn't feel as chaotic to me now. I think that it's nice that she went in a different direction than the last year's contestant and the contestant from 2 years ago. It's not a ballad, but it's a dance song, so I think it's nice that we have some sort of variety. Well done. Let's move on. Okay, so next up on our list is Bulgaria, represented by the Intelligent Music Project and your song Intention. Blah 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 blah. And this part, I have to quote this because it's pretty funny to me. Intelligent Music Project's open-minded approach has resulted in them working, recording, and performing with names that have previously collaborated with the likes of Toto, Black Sabbath, Stevie Wonder, Phil Collins, and many more besides. So basically, they know a guy who knows a guy. I love that they brag about that. Anyway, I gotta tell you that the name of the band, Intelligent Music Project, it really rubs me the wrong way. I remember when I was a teenager and I listened to rock music. This is also a rock band, by the way, just so we know. I used to think that oh, this is intelligent music for intelligent people, and that listening to rock somehow made me superior to people who listen to other genres of music. I hate that I was like this. Nowadays, I really hate people who are superior, snobbish, that sort of thing. So maybe I'm projecting too much onto them right now. But yeah, I'm just not a huge fan of that band name. Okay, let's listen. Yeah, so right off the bat, to me, sounds a little bit too upbeat, too cheerful. I kind of like darker rock songs. I feel like there's a little bit too much rasp in the voice of the vocalist. Like, we get it, yeah, you're singing rock. Don't overdo it. I would also like the... I don't like the fact that they just repeat the chorus twice. And it's the same both of those times. I would have preferred if they had like a different lyric. Right. I gotta say, I admire the fact that they have a guitar solo. Like, how many bands do guitar solos nowadays? No one. Okay, and there's another issue that I have with this song. I feel like, because the chorus goes like, safety zone, and then they're sending me to war. Again, I'm running into the same issue as always, that I'm just my lack of knowledge of music terminology, so I don't know exactly how to explain to you what I'm talking about here. But basically, like, his voice kind of is oscillating around that note, and it's pretty long. I would have liked especially the war part to be more punchy and shorter. I would have liked him to just say, they're sending me to war, and finish there. I think that it would have sounded just edgier, more aggressive, would be more rock and roll. I think that probably in the live performance there will be a little bit more variation in the singing, and probably it will be better actually. But in general, the chorus is very catchy. Like, you kind of memorize the lyrics very quickly because they just repeat the same thing over and over again. That actually, you know, in a way, it could be a good thing for them because, you know, the audiences will pick it up very quickly. Right, I completely forgot to mention that, of course, Intelligent Music Project was chosen internally by the Bulgarian broadcaster. Boo! And the song is, as you could hear, in English, so boo! Okay. Now we can really move on. Next on our list is Czech Republic, represented by We Are Domi and their song Lights Off. So We Are Domi were selected in the national selection, so yay! The song is in English though, so boo! We Are Domi is made up of Dominika Haškova, who's Czech, and she's the lead singer of the band. And then also, apart from her, there's Kasper Kattelstad and Benjamin Rekstad, who are both Norwegian. They all met in Yorkshire, UK. Then they all three of them moved to Prague, and they now live in Prague, and that's where they make music. And yeah, all right. And so they debuted in 2019. So it's they're still pretty fresh, we could say. This is of course the performance from the Czech national selection. So this is a live performance. Which, by the way, I really like the staging for the Czech national selection. I think they did a pretty good job. Because it looks pretty cool. Where are you now? Where are you now? Where are you now? Where are you now? Okay, I think you can tell that I like this. I really like the vocals. I love her energy. I think that the music is really catchy. It really kind of gets you going. Yeah, you really want to dance to this. Where are you now? I gotta say, I really like this. It reminds me a little bit of that entry, the Belarusian entry from 2020. I liked it, which I liked a lot. It was so great. This song is giving me very much like strumming my pain with his fingers vibe. You know, when I hear try changing jobs, try changing lovers, changing my furniture, change my bed covers, I feel very attacked right now. Yeah, I changed my heart, but there's not a chance. Yeah, where are you now when I miss you? I mean, this is my life now, basically. I think this is what's actually amazing about lyrical music, that you know, you can really feel like, oh, there's someone out there who's going through the same thing as you, and you can feel understood and seen and not so alone. And that's always something that drew me to music. Next up on our list is Estonia, represented by Stefan with the song Hope. So it was selected in the national selection, so yay! But the song is in English, so boo! So Stefan has already participated in Eesti Laulu, the official selection for the Eurovision Song Contest, 4 times. I mean, this is his fourth time. He also won the first season of the Estonian version of The Masked Singer. And again, I have to quote this. Appearing on national television, all overheated and under-groomed from beneath the heavy costume did his reputation in the looks department no harm. Later that year, the popular magazine Kronika named him as the sexiest man of the year in Estonia. So Estonia once again sends us their sexiest man. I mean, clearly we can see what their strategy is here. It didn't work for them last year though, so I don't know, maybe they should switch it up a bit, but let's hear the song. The song is the most important, obviously. Okay. I mean, you immediately can tell like what this is, right? So actually his entry from 2018 was also a bit country sounding, but that one was more like just regular country slash rock. Whereas this is basically like Western music or cowboy pop. It's you know, in that same kind of category as like the theme song from Rawhide or like Ghost Riders in the Sky, you know, which is interesting. I don't think we have that genre represented at the Eurovision Song Contest before. I'm wondering where they shot this, honestly, because this is definitely not Estonia, I think. Is it Spain? Usually it's Spain that, you know, plays Wild West in European movies. I see that the crew that worked on the music video, they all have Spanish last names, so I was right. This is probably Spain. I gotta say, I think the chorus is pretty catchy, right? Again, the lyrics are super simple, so we can immediately start singing along, and you know, I kind of like this. I am the fan of like, you know, Ennio Morricone's score for the, you know, Sergio Leone's, you know, Spaghetti Western trilogy with Clint Eastwood. Although normally if you ask me, I would tell you that country is like my least favorite genre of music, but you know, this kind of like cowboy vibe, I dig that for some reason. It's a good song. So I expect it to do well actually in the contest, but of course we'll see. Next on our list is Ireland, represented by Brooke. We have the song That's Rich. Brooke was chosen for national selection, so yay! But the song, unfortunately, is in English, so boo! And yeah, again, before you come for me, why don't the Irish singers ever sing in Irish? One time! I'm asking just one time! Brooke is a pretty young artist. She was a finalist in the 2020 series of The Voice UK. Apparently, she had the first four-tier turn of that series. The song that she has co-written. She says that her main influences for that song were Blondie and The Gossip, which totally makes sense to me, you know, now that I think of it, because I was trying to pinpoint what that song reminded me of, and I was thinking of that band Shiny Toy Guns. It's a very 2010 kind of sound. It's kind of interesting, I think. It does sound a lot like The Gossip, for instance. But you could say it also sounds a lot like Shiny Toy Guns. Just saying. I definitely think it's very sassy. It's a very energetic song, which is good. It's catchy for sure. In many ways, this is a very, I think, successful entry. I mean, like, we don't know that yet. I mean, I think it might be a really successful entry. Next country on our list is Israel, represented by Michael Ben David with the song I Am. And he was chosen for national selection, so yay! But the song is in English, so boo! Okay, so Michael Ben David is 25 years old. Obviously, he won the X Factor Israel because that's how they select their contestants. They say that he hails from Petah Tikva. I know a thing about Petah Tikva. I know that it's one of the earliest, if not the earliest, Jewish settlement. You could say that it's basically the oldest town in modern Israel history, right? So Michael Ben David is of Russian, Georgian, and Ukrainian descent. Okay, let's listen to the song. So this is a live performance from the final of X Factor. Sometimes life can bring you down. You can say that I'm stunning, it's not a shame. Cause I know he's got great moves. Gosh. It's like, okay, they added that Middle Eastern flair. Smart. You know you're gonna win my heart with this. It feels a little bit like Nadav Guj's Golden Boy, but queer. Gonna win the crown. Wow. Well, you know, great energy for sure. It's not boring. That's good. I still have a feeling like this one is a little bit, again, slightly disjointed. I can't believe I'm saying this because you know that I am more is more kind of person. But I kind of just want it to be cohesive though. Like, yeah, sure. Like, throw a lot of shit in there. But just make sure that it all kind of makes sense. You know, I hate it when the song is like fast, fast, fast. Then suddenly it like slows down and then it picks up again. I don't like that. I don't like that. I just like, you know, I like it to be steady. I especially like the songs that kind of start off a bit slower and then they grow, they become faster or, you know, louder and kind of more complex. Like there's more instruments added to the mix and there's, you know, like a big finish to it. This is very popular right now to make songs like this, which are kind of have these sort of awkward pauses and changes in the tempo or something. I don't like that. I just don't like that. Anyway, I think that this is a fun entry. Good luck with that. Let's move on. Next on our list are contestants from Italy. Mahmoud and Blanco. Of course, I don't have to introduce Mahmoud to you. You know that he is the Italian contestant from 2019 and he came second then. And I really liked him. He was one of my favorites to win that year. So it's exciting to see him back. Blanco, on the other hand, is a total newcomer to Eurovision. He's also very young. He's 18 only, so he'll be one of the youngest contestants this year. Their song was obviously chosen for national selection because this is Italy. So, yay! And the song is in Italian, so yay! I'm thinking this is quite bold of Italy to go with an artist that already represented them in the past, because you know...
That shit don't work twice, playboy!
Exactly. Of course, except when it does, like in the case of Dima Bilan and Johnny Logan, but that was his name, Johnny Logan. But yeah, back when Johnny Logan was winning Eurovision, people had no taste, and also Eurovision was crap. Also, when Dima Bilan won that second time around when he competed, like, come on, like, 2008 was garbage. Was garbage. And everybody knows that it wasn't actually Dima Bilan winning, it was Yevgeny Plushenko, because Yevgeny Plushenko wins everything, except for the Salt Lake City Olympics, but everyone knows that those Olympics were famously rigged, and Alexei Yagudin only won because the judges took pity on him because he was retiring that year, and that's why they gave him the gold medal. Everyone knows Plushenko actually won those Olympic Games. Fight me on this. Actually, no, don't fight me on this, because you're gonna lose. Well, let's listen to the song. Mahmoud's voice is just so distinctive. You just, the moment you hear it, you know, like, oh, that's Mahmoud. And I think that just the sheer distinctiveness of that voice, it just makes it so much more kind of interesting to listen to. I really like their voices together. I love when they sing in unison, because it really feel like their voices complement each other. Usually I don't like it when singers just perform the song, like, you know, a duet, and they sing in unison. I usually hate those parts, because most singers sound pretty similar, honestly. Like, but in this case, I feel like this is a great pairing. Okay, well, that was a beautiful performance, I think. However, I have to say, I don't like this song as much as I liked Soldi. But at the same time, I mean, maybe just the story, the, you know, just the performance on stage might sell it. Yeah, one more thing about the lyrics, right? They say, we never mention the word love because it is not just about love, but the desire to get involved and take risks. Rather than love, it is throwing yourself into the dark. The main theme of chills, so brividi, is the discomfort of not feeling 100% accepted. And the line goes like, I would like to love you, but I'm always wrong and I get chills. Honestly, could you stop killing me softly with these songs, please? Of course, that adds to the song if the lyrics actually have some deep meaning to them. So, good job. The last entry for today is Latvia, represented by Citi Zeni with the song Eat Your Salad. The song was selected in the National Selection Supernova, so yay! The song, unfortunately, is in English, so boo! Citi Zeni described their musical style as Eastern European alternative unicorn pop. So they try to bring humor to their music. Well, there's not that much to say about them, because they've only released their first album last year in October, so... Yeah, so literally like a couple of months ago. Let's just listen to the song. This is, of course, the live performance from the final of the Supernova. I can't hate on these lyrics. I ride my bike to work instead of a car. Great. Eat your veggies, duh. Reusable bag. This is giving me very much like the vibe of Eurovision from like 20 years ago. So some good soul posted the lyrics to the song in the comments. At least I can check what he's singing about, because honestly, they could enunciate
a little bit better, I think.
How much cocaine has this guy snorted before going on the stage? No one has that much energy. So, as I said, a good soul has posted the lyrics to this song in the comments. Because it goes like, being green is sexy as fuck, being green is hot, being... Yeah, I don't think that they can sing fuck on the Eurovision stage. They'll have to amend that, I'm pretty sure. Eat your salad, save the planet, being green is sexy as you. And so on and so forth. You get the gist, right? Honestly, I'm a bit conflicted about this entry. Like, okay, if this is supposed to be a funny entry, then what is actually the joke? Either the joke is that, you know, being green is actually super lame, right? And being eco-friendly is super lame, right? And we're pretending like it's cool, but it's actually not cool. And that's the joke, right? Of course, that wouldn't be great. And I also don't think that this is the case. I think that they are genuine, right? They are serious about the actual, like, message in the song. But if you are serious about the message, then there's nothing funny in these lyrics, honestly. Like, instead of meat, I eat veggies and pussy, which they won't be able to sing on the stage. Okay, there's stuff like, very, very crude stuff like, forget the hot dogs, because my sausage is bigger. It's just not, I think, a very successful attempt at a humorous entry. But then again, also the underlying message that we, like, individual consumers, we're responsible for making the right choices. It's really not about individual choices. We know that it has to be dealt by governments regulating big business, not by us using reusable bags. That's not a viable solution. So that's another problem that I have with this song, is that it's still kind of hammering that message. We should have moved on from this by now. It's a different thing making people go vegan. If everybody went vegan, that would actually change a lot. But I don't think it's a very realistic plan. Like, you're not gonna get people to do that. As much as I would love to force people to be vegan, but it's just not gonna work. So, we gotta have a different approach to this. Okay, so this is it for today, and that was the last song. So, I'm deciding to crown Czech Republic the winner of this episode. Congratulations! If I had to pick my least favorite, that would probably be Latvia. What can I do? Try better next time, Latvia, okay? Alright, so thank you very much for today. I'll see you on the next episode of EUROSIS. And yeah, leave a like and a comment under this video, because of course that would help me out in the YouTube algorithm. And I know that I'm not a very serious content creator. I don't bring content regularly. I only do this 2 months out of a year. But you know, it definitely would make me feel good if you showed me that you appreciated what I did. I do put in quite a lot of work in making this. Like, if you don't make your own videos, you have no idea. But no pressure. If you don't want to, if you didn't like it, that's okay. Just walk away. You don't have to give a dislike. Obviously, no one's gonna see the dislikes, but you know who's gonna see them? I'm gonna see them. So please do not leave any dislikes, because that makes me sad. Okay, that's it. I'm finished. Thank you very much. See you next time. Bye!